Hello everyone. Today we will discuss about another important group of minerals in the orthosilicate group. They are garnet group of minerals. In this lecture, I'll discuss about the structure and composition of garnet group of minerals belongs to the orthosilicates. The references I have used are shown in the slide at the bottom. Garnets are very common nesosilicate minerals, especially in metamorphic rocks. They are also found in some igneous rocks as minor constituent and as a detrital grain in the sediments. It is frequently used as an index mineral in the delineation of isograds in metamorphic rocks. Now, let's discuss about the composition and structure of garnets. Garnets belongs to the isometric system, and minerals in the garnet groups are generally isostructural. Their structural formula may be represented by X3, Y2, Si3 or 12, in which X site is occupied by cations in the cubic site and Y sites are occupied by cations having octahedral coordination. Well, let's see what are the cations that occur in the X sites. These are generally divalent cations like Ca2+, Mg2+, Fe2+, and Mn2+. Whereas if you see the position occupied by cations in the octahedral site belongs to trivalent cations such as Al3+, Fe3+, and Cr3+. When you look about the structure of garnet, it consists of isolated silicon tetrahedra bounded laterally through cations in 6-fold and 8-fold coordination. The silica tetrahedral and Y octahedra share single oxygen anions to form chains extending parallel to each of the A axis. The spaces between these chains are distorted 8-fold sites occupied by the X cations. This diagram shows the simplified version of a garnet structure in a plane 001, which has a framework of alternating tetrahedra that is shown in purple color and octahedra shown in blue color and dodecahedra approximating to distorted cubes which are shown in yellow color. Containing at their centers is silica, then trivalent Y cation and divalent X cations respectively. Here the divalent cations that is shown in the yellow distorted cube is occupied by calcium, magnesium, iron and manganese. Whereas the trivalent Y cations, the sites are occupied by aluminium, iron and chromium. Shared oxygens are at the corners of the polyhedra and links within and between successive slices to form a 3D framework. Tetrahedra are not linked directly to one another. Thus, the garnet is an orthosilicate. This was the same case that we observed in olivine, in which also the SiO4 tetrahedra is not directly linked to one another, but are linked by the cations in the octahedral position. Here also, isolated silicon tetrahedra share single oxygen anions with Y cations in 6-fold coordination is shown. The spaces between are distorted 8-fold sites occupied by the larger X cations, which are represented by calcium, magnesium, iron and manganese. Experimental studies at high pressure and temperature shows that garnet structure is stable in Earth's mantle condition, which means that it is stable at relatively high pressure and temperature condition. It appears that pyrope-type compositions are most likely in the pressure and temperature regime of Earth mantle. Now, when you discuss about the composition of garnet, due to size consideration in the filling of the X sites, we may expect a well-defined division of garnet into those with calcium having larger cationic size and those with easily interchangeable divalent ions such as magnesium, iron and manganese. Due to the limited substitution possible in the Y sites, we may also separate garnet into aluminium, iron and chromium bearing at the octahedral site. So these two trends are well marked and had given rise to a grouping of garnet into two series, that are pyralpsite and ugrandite. In pyralpsite series, you have magnesium, iron and manganese, as indicated here, that because of the size constraints, calcium, which is having a relatively larger size, go into the oxides in some type of garnet, or in the other type, because of the similarity in their sizes, magnesium, iron and manganese go into the oxides. So in pyralpsite series, magnesium, iron and manganese go into the oxides, and in the Y octahedral side, the trivalent cation aluminium is occupied, and along with that you have the structural series Si3O12 is also present in the end of the formula. And when you look into the ugrandite series, the X sites are occupied by calcium, whereas Y sites are occupied by trivalent cations such as chromium, aluminium and iron. And along with that, it is associated with Si3O12. This forms the general formula for pyralpsite series and ugrandite series. One site is occupied by trivalent cation aluminium, whereas in ugrandite series, X site is occupied by calcium, that is in the cubic site or 8-fold coordination site. When you talk about the pyralpsite group, it includes a solid solution of pyrope, almandine and spessartine. So the first names of the pyrope, almandine and spessartine is taken together to forms the name of pyralpsite. Whereas in case of ugrandite, the names of uaurovite, grossular and andradite are used to form the name ugrandite, that is uaurovite, grossular and andradite, that forms the name of the ugrandite series. And there occurs solid solution with a composition, as we have discussed, Ca3CrAlFe2SiO12. Extensive substitution of magnesium, iron and manganese is possible in the X site in the pyralpsite group, as we have discussed. As we have discussed in the former slide about the pyralpsite and ugrandite series, the pyralpsite series originated its name from components of the series, that is pyrope, almandine and spessartine. Pyrope has a general formula of Mg3Al2Si3O12, and almandine has a general formula of Fe3Al2Si3O12. Whereas in case of spessartine, it is Mn3Al2Si3O12. So we have already discussed that in the X sites, because of the size constraints, the divalent cations such as magnesium, iron and manganese occupy the X sites. So similarly, we had also mentioned that aluminium occupy in the octahedral position. So if you see at the chemical formula of pyrope, almandine and spessartine, you can see that one of these cations occupy its X site, and aluminium is always occupied at the octahedral site and followed by Si3O12. If you look into the ugrandite, the name is derived from U stands for uaurovite, Gr stands for grossularite and And stands for andradite. So in uaurovite series, if you recall from our previous slide, all of the X site is occupied by calcium, and the Y site, that is the octahedral site, is occupied by trivalent cations such as chromium, aluminium and iron, Fe3+. So if you look into the chemical formula of uaurovite, it is Ca3Cr2Si3O12, and for grossular it is Ca3Al2Si3O12, and for andradite it is Ca3Fe2+Si3O12. So calcium occurring in X site, and the cations, the trivalent cations like chromium, aluminium and iron is occurring at the octahedral site, that is Cr2 in case of uaurovite, and aluminium in case of grossular, and iron in case of andradite. So this is how the chemical formula of different minerals of garnet group is formed. So if you see the distribution of the garnet, most natural pyralpsite garnet of composition fall between pyrope and almandine, or between almandine and spessartine. So that is how the chemical composition are distributed. The continuous solid solution is also present between grosseller and andradite in the grandite group. That is, grandite group term is used when you consider grosseller and andradite. Extensive substitution occurs among the minerals of the pyralspite group and among the minerals of the eugrandite group, but relatively little solid solution between these two major categories happens. Garnet, with a general composition of MgFeCa thrice Al2Si3O12, that is magnesium, iron and calcium in its X position, that is in the cubic side, and aluminium in its octahedral side. So this having an intermediate between the two groups, eugrandite and pyralsite group, is found at higher temperature, that is greater than 700 degrees Celsius, in metamorphic rocks. There is another way of classifying garnet is based on the ions in the Y side, which yields there are three unequal groups. That is, the Y side is occupied by aluminium, iron and chromium. If it is occupied by aluminium, that is the octahedral position is occupied by aluminium, then we call it as aluminium garnet. And if it is occupied by iron, then we call it as ferric garnet. And if it is occupied by chromium, then we call it as chrome garnet. So if you look into the composition, in that aspect, all the garnet which having aluminium in its octahedral position are grouped into one set, called it as aluminium garnet, which includes pyrope, almandine, spessartine and grosseller. And if you look into the Y site where iron is occupied, then we group it as ferric garnet, that we call it as andradite. And chromium bearing garnet, we call it as URY. Titanium may also enter in the Y site along with the replacement of calcium by sodium in its X sites, that produce a garnet called melanite, which is black in color. In melanite, which is a titanium variety of andradite, you know andradite is a Ca3Fe2Si3O12, where the octahedral position is occupied by iron. So this Fe3 plus always greater than Ti in the octahedral site. If Fe3 plus is less than Ti in its octahedral site, such garnets are called scholomite. Okay, so if it is occupied by higher proportion of iron in its octahedral position compared to titanium, then we call it as melanite. And if it is having less proportion of iron compared to titanium in its octahedral position, then we call the mineral as scholomite. Other rare occurrences of garnet include a hydrated variety of garnet known as hydrogrosselerite, which is having a composition of Ca3Al2Si2O8, and part of the SiO4 tetrahedra is replaced by hydroxyl group. It contains up to 8.5% of water. Compositions containing Mg3Cr2Si3O12, that is chromium is occurring in its octahedral position, are termed as noringite. These are now recognized as an important constituent in some kimberlitic garnets. Garnet analog of grosseller and andradite containing vanadium as a major component in its octahedral site is termed as goldmanite. So which is having a chemical composition of Ca3V2, which is vanadium Si3O12. Zirconium occurs as a minor constituent in some titanium andradites. A garnet with zircon as a major component had been named as kimseyite. Its ideal formula is Ca3Zr2Al2SiO12 with aluminium and silica in its tetrahedral position, with some titanium may replacing zircon and iron replacing aluminium.